I used to be a ski instructor. I was obsessed with skiing. I followed winters around the world. I wanted to get better every day, and I would get so frustrated when my skills plateaued because learning to ski technically well is, well, there's no shortcuts. And then I discovered snowmobiling. I found riding a snowmobile pretty easy to start with, slacking around trails and old Yamahas. But then I got a mountain sled, and I realized how difficult snowmobiling really is. Riding a sled in the mountains is easily as technical as alpine skiing, and it's just as frustrating if you think you need to be good at it, with a bonus of wrapping 10 or 15,000 bucks of snowmobile around a tree when you get it wrong. I've still got such a long way to go, but I started to make progress when I realized that skiing and snowmobiling are fundamentally the same sport. And I found that lots of the tricks I learned as a ski instructor work just as well on a sled. So, I've made some videos explaining how I think ski technique has helped me learn to ride a snowmobile. And in each video I'm going to introduce one idea from ski teaching and show how I've been using it to try to learn to ride a sled. One thing I'm not going to do is tell anyone specifically how to ride a snowmobile. For that you need to listen to Next Level, BBA, Ride Rasmussen, all those guys. They're actual experts, proper teachers as well as being amazing riders. I'm just a ski guy trying to work stuff out. And if no one cares, I'll make videos about how to milk a cow. The first skiing idea that helped me ride a sled was stupid obvious. It's the ski. In alpine skiing, most of the work is done by one ski, the outside ski, and it's not even all the outside ski. It's mainly the inside edge of your outside ski, you know, your downhill ski. I know there's all sorts of stuff you do with the other ski and the other edges, but if you can't work the inside edge of your outside ski, you'll never be a good skier. So my approach to riding a snowmobile totally changed when I realized that a mountain sled, is basically a pair of skis with a motor. And it changed again when I realized it's not even really a pair of skis, it's mainly about one ski, or at least one ski at a time. In fact, not even one whole ski. Riding a sled in the mountains is mainly about what you do to one side of one ski. I mean, there's so much to think about on a snowmobile, how to hold the bars, how to steer it, track speed, foot position, throttle braking, blah, blah, blah. But it has helped me to simplify it all down to one main thing, just like skiing, and that main thing is getting on edge, one edge. So which edge is it? Which side of the ski are you aiming at? If you paint the bottom of one ski, then the paint on the outside edge, that's the furthest away from the engine, will wear off much quicker when you ride it, because that's the edge doing all the work. That's the edge you're balancing on, and that's the edge that's rubbing across the snow crystal, so the paint wears off. Look at a mountain rider ski even without paint on it, and you can see that the scratches are concentrated on that one part of the outside of each ski, and that's where you'll take a chunk out if you hit a rock or a stump. Everything's happening to that edge. I do realize this is kind of basic, but I found with skiing, it's surprising how often you can improve just by thinking specifically about what you're trying to make one edge do. So when I'm skiing, I might be thinking about rolling onto the inside of my foot to put the ski on edge as early as possible in the turn. And on my sled, instead of thinking vaguely about kind of tipping the snowmobile over, I try to think about balancing the sled on that specific outside edge of the inside ski, and that seems to help me get over to where it needs to be. Also helped me realize how far over the balance point is on that edge. It's way over there, and being too far over is much easier to recover from than not being far enough. I've got a couple of drills from skiing that I've swapped over to snowmobiling, and they seem to be useful, or at least they were for me. If you're already a good mountain rider, these probably won't do anything for you. But if, like me, you're still getting the hang of putting a sled on edge in the mountains, this might help get you going. So the first ski teaching drill I used to call ABC, always be carving. And the idea was to pick a destination and commit to being on your edges 100% of the time while you get there, so you're never on a flat ski. You'll see ski instructors do this instinctively. Their students will be strung out behind them, riding flat skis across a flat section of a run, the part where they think there's nothing to learn, nothing to do. But the instructor will be rolling smoothly from edge to edge, covering probably twice the distance in clean arcs, but still having to slow down for the group. And you can do exactly the same thing on a sled. On terrain where normally you just ride the snowmobile on both skis, you know, getting from A to B, because it's flat or boring, you're going to tip it on edge and carve one way or another, whether you, air quotes, need to or not. And you keep a mental tab of how often you failed by dropping back onto two skis. This is easy when you're in an open meadow, but it gets much harder when you're on hardpack, or following a forest road, or on mixed forelines, or someplace with consequences if you screw up. And what I found is, when I kept skiing or riding this way, it reached the stage where I feel kind of weird or wrong, even kind of dangerous to have both skis flat on the snow, almost like I'm not actually snowmobiling. And from my perspective, learning to ride a mountain sled, I figure this is a good thing, because I've learned that if I can't get on edge, I'm going nowhere in the real mountains, no matter how good I am at grabbing the mountain bar and hanging off the uphill side of the sled. So I'm going kind of long here, but let me give you one more trick from skiing and snowboarding that might be helpful on a sled. The idea is to go back and look at the marks left by your skis as you transition from one direction to the other. In alpine skiing, the track tells the story of each turn. Shape, edge angle, timing, pressure control, basically everything important is written in the snow after you've been there. And it's the same on a sled. The track can show you exactly how long you were riding two skis between turns and what happened when you're on edge. Obviously, you can't be in deep powder for this because you need to be able to see each ski track. But here's one where I was flat for several meters, you know, doing nothing, all fluidity lost. And here's one where you can see that I rolled directly from one ski to the other. So if those skis had paint on them, you know, which part of the paint would be wearing off? Now, clearly, you're not going to spend all day going back to look at your tracks. That would be kind of weird. Spending too long looking in the toilet bowl. But if you've never done this, give it a go. It showed me at least that carving a turn on a snowmobile, particularly on firm snow, is a lot like carving a turn on skis. Sure, it's the opposite ski because on a sled you're on the inside ski, but it feels the same. And just like skiing, when I'm on edge, I feel like I'm in control and all the options are available to me. And by the way, that's another drill I took from skiing. You make linked turns rolling from edge to edge with zero flat spot. It's going straight from side to side, and then you try the same thing with a definite flat spot, a sort of dead spot between each turn, like this. It's just a variation on the ABC thing I mentioned earlier to make you aware of when you're on edge and when you're not. If you're like me, you'll find that after each flat spot, you basically have to start all over again, counter-steering more, making more effort, and also getting distracted by small terrain or snow changes that you think you're going to mess you up and you're going to have to do something about. Whereas if you link turns together continuously and look way ahead, nearly all those terrain distractions go away. It's the same in skiing as it is in snowmobiling. So there you have it. A couple of thoughts from a crapped out ski instructor. I'm learning to ride just like you are. So let me know if you've got ideas that have helped you and I'll try them out. My next vid is going to be about blipping the gas. You may think this has got nothing at all to do with skiing, but I used to be a dairy farmer. I was obsessed with milking cows. I followed cows around the world. I wanted to get better every day. And I'd get so frustrated when my skills plateaued because learning to milk cows technically well is... And then I discovered snowmobiling.